Hey guys, my name is Ork. Welcome to the new video. Today we're going to talk about Blackout, which is battle royale mode in Call of Duty Black Ops 4. For you guys who don't know, the beta was last week, and yesterday, sadly, it's ended. And we're going to talk a lot bit about that. So I separate things in good and bad way. What I think about Call of Duty Blackout beta. And first thing first, let's say, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to my channel. That would be awesome, thank you. And now, first thing first, we're going to talk about good things, then about bad things. So, the first thing, really good one, that's like number one on my list, is the Blackout Battle Royale feel like Call of Duty. I know none other FPS game could copy that. Call of Duty has its own feeling when you play it, you will know it's Call of Duty. The Blackout, no exception about that. Multiplayer beta was like months ago as well, no comparison, there's Call of Duty thing. There is no question about that. Next thing, how smooth the Battle Royale was actually running. I'm talking from perspective who was playing on PlayStation 4 Pro. That was no problems at all. It was really smooth. There's a couple of small disconnected, but it's beta, we need to close one eye on that. And but in general, really smooth one. I asked my friend that was playing a normal PlayStation 4 and they said it was smooth. And so I don't know, my friend didn't have any experience of a bad, not smoothing game, so it's really good one. So the third thing I want to talk about is map is nice, perfect size in my opinion. Such a nice spread of map, everything is connected really nice. With wingsuit that you actually drop when you're coming down, you can went a really long way and skip some of the town. You can easily get on any part of the map, and I think that's really good. So there's in the Blackout map is actually the map from Blackout series in general, and they fit like perfectly. They make them look so natural in their position on the map. It's unbelievable how good they actually did that, and I think it's awesome. I wouldn't change anything. Also the thing that I want to mention is zombies part on the Blackout map, really good. I really don't have anything against. I think I'm not the biggest zombie players in the world, but I think I really love how they implement that, and that's the thing that will change actually. That will make the Blackout the special battle royale game in my opinion, with that zombies implemented from Call of Duty series. The next thing is on the map, there you can be a lot and lot really creative. You can jump on any basically roof if you think a little bit about how to do that. You can use a grapple gun and do whatever you want basically on that. So I think that's really positive thing that without the grapple gun you can easily jump on some on pretty much all roofs. And especially fire range, this is like the best example. You can jump on everything that I know easily. Which is really good, that makes the game better, and it's fun to play too. The next thing, gunfight sound is really good. You know, you can easily hear where enemy are really far away from you. You can easily know about where are they, and I think that's really good. That's something that battle royale games need to have, I think, in my opinion, to know. So somebody who will rush a lot and just wants to have a gunfight, that's really good. So that things that next thing is vehicles. They're simple, they're good, they're made to get you from one point A to point B, and they're useful for that. They're perfect if you have them. They're not overpowered, like I heard it's H1Z1, you're the freaking king if you have them. Here you can easily die if you have them, but they're really good for getting you from point one to point B. And I don't have anything much to say. Also, they add that PC in the game, speed of the game, they really make it up a little bit faster than it just without running. So I think in general they're good, I wouldn't change anything on that. Next thing I want to say this is first thing, new thing in Call of Duty that we have never before had, is bullet drop. They made that fantastic. It make really hard to kill somebody if you're not used to. And basically, if you can hit some long shots, that make a difference in skills. There's now skills in making that long shot kills. It's not that easy to kill somebody on the wrong gauge because of bullet drop. You don't know how much or bullet drop. And I think they handle it perfectly. I will say anything about that. I think it's really good. The last good thing is the wingsuit. I think what I played PUBG, I played H1Z1, I played Fortnite, and this. I played multiple battle royale games, and I think the wingsuit was the best of the best how to drop system. You can easily wingsuit all over the map. Across that, you can jump over some high buildings like a structure site. And I think perfect. I will change anything wingsuit basically. And I think that was a great idea from Treyarch. And yeah, now the side that we call the bad side. This is things that need to change. They're a little bit annoying and they're not bad in a way that need to be removed completely. They need a little bit of tuning. So first thing first, and I think this is the biggest, and everybody know what I will say now. Armor. There is such a big difference from having no armor to have level 1 armor, and then from level 1 to level 2, level 2 and level 3, there is way too much big difference, and armor needs to change. There is multiple good ideas for that, but I will not go into that right now. I just say that armor needs to be changed, because when you have in the gunfight, basically armor is warning camping and waiting for enemy and destroying the rushing tactics, because when you rush, you will get into gunfights. There is big chance if you get a kill, you will get their loot, but they will destroy your armor, except you're coming from somebody behind you. They will destroy your armor, so if they destroy your armor, you are screwed. You're not in good position anymore. You'll have their loot, yes, I will agree with that, but that doesn't make anything because you have armor, no armor, and you're disadvantaged against somebody else in the gunfight you'll take next. So basically the system right now is rewarding camping, more camping style gameplay instead of rushing, and they need to change a little bit tune to armor. There is multiple good idea how to do that, so I have complete faith in Treyarch Studio, so I'm sure they will do a good job about that. Next is footsteps. They're good, they're loud, you can easily spot them if you don't have, even if a normal headset, you'll really hear them. But their problem, they're difficult to know where you are, they're difficult to know where enemy is. Especially your teammates in squad, they're really loud, they're way too loud and really messy to understand where somebody is. They will need to tune a little bit about that. Already know that's bug in sound, so I'm sure they will do something about that to make it better. Next thing is a loot. You need to have your, I mean, loot in general is good, dropping is good. You should have been able to see the loot before we actually jump to the ground while we are wingsuiting, but that's fine completely, I don't mind that much. But loot, I mean by loot is, You need to have your head way too low to able to see and pick up the gun. Your head should be like straight up, and you should be able still to pick up, but we can't. We need to make our head low, so low down, so it's real hard to spot enemy in that way. And also, at least in PlayStation and Xbox, I think we are holding the button way too long for pickup. To compare to the PC, which is much faster to pick up. On PlayStation and Xbox One especially, I'll talk about PlayStation. It's way too long and it's actually quite hard to loot quickly somebody. Next thing is, which is bug to be honest, but I'll mention it here. When you're looting somebody, there is good chance you will not be able to go left and right to see everything. You need to quit the bag and go back. Treyarch already, I think, mentioned that it's a bug that they will fix now in leader testing, and I'm hoping it's really annoying when you get good fun some terrible situation, you want to maybe just quick tap to the like ammo or something, and you just can't. The bag is fucked. But nevertheless, again, fate completely dragged. I think they'll fix that. There's no big issue there. Now player count 88. It's good. In some situation, you feel a little bit slow. There is nobody. I cannot find anybody. But okay, that will find it. We have actually 2 hours. They extend beta for 2 hours, and we have been able to play with 100 players. That run extremely smooth as well. I didn't have any problem with that 2 hours. And with 100 players, I didn't feel like too much. That low part where nobody is, it's really cut down to the minimum. So basically, every there is a lot of gunfights going on. There will be anyone can be anywhere. And I think 100 players, it was good. I heard that we got information that today for testing we had 115 players. I really love to see that, but 100, that was running really smooth. Go with that. I think there's no problem with anybody with that. And I think it's really good system with 100 players. And the last thing I want to mention, which is not actually bad thing, not either good thing, there's like just a little bit complain, but I understand that one. The graphics are not amazing. I'm not shocked how good the game looks. But to be honest, I would rather have these graphics. This is like normal graphic, like I would say average graphic. Nothing too good, nothing too special. I would rather have that and have this performance than having good graphic and bad performance. So this is just a mention to the end of the video to know that graphic is not amazing at the moment. I think this will be better, will be Blackout will be after the release as well. The graphics not amazing, but I love the performance. It was really good, and a couple of disconnected and some glitches, but that's better. You cannot take it for granted here. And yeah, guys, this is the end of the video. A little bit a longer one today, but nevertheless, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed my commentary over it. And make sure to like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you guys in a new video soon. Peace.